Hey guys, I know I made a video today, but nobody said that I couldn't make more than one, and so, listen to this for a few seconds, and then I'll talk. Okay, so now that you heard that was because I wanted you to listen to that, and then you to figure out what I'm going to talk about. When people say technology ruins people's lives, I don't believe that technology can ruin your life. Unless, of course, you are using technology all day, every day, but technology can be a good thing. Until you listen to music. That's what I want to talk about today. I want to talk about music. So, something from most people's favorite artists. Of course, you might guess by this song. Everyone knows this person, and so I'm going to play this. Just a minute, I got to take it back. Okay, and let's.
This is Michael Buckley from the What the Buck Show, and today I'm going to review the music video for Bang Bang, huh?
Okay, yes, wrong one, sorry. Had I known that was that tight, I wouldn't have hit TikTok. Okay, here we are. It's the locker. Now let's listen to another one. So let me get my music. Go to search for music. Love to Miley Cyrus. By the time you hear all that, you'll understand what I'm talking about. Never mind. Let me pull this hat up. Hold on. But basically, I just want you to hear that snip and see the good music from him. Music that everyone else calls good. Now, let's play this one. Hold on. Okay. I'm not getting fucked like that. I didn't. Oh, I just picked it. Most of you know this one, Gentleman Satan's of King. Now this. It's most preferred over others, rather than Anaconda. I don't know what's doing. And other ones. Yeah. This is gospel. It's actually relaxing. Just like any other gospel song. The I'm all charged out. Yes, and I just did it also.
Oh, so the comments you like, I really don't care.
Because what doesn't kill me makes me stronger. So, that's what I wanted to speak about too. Hold on, I'm tearing the volume down. If you assess my substitute teacher once, that if you don't have haters, then you must be doing something wrong. Because whatever doesn't kill you literally makes you stronger physically. Not physically, but mentally. And for those who believe in spirituality, it actually builds you up spiritually too. So, instead of listening to all that junk, listen to stuff like this. And I believe that your haters are not necessarily jealous of you, but they feel like you have something that they don't, and they want to try to bring you down to their level or whatever, and try to bring you down to make you seem like a person who isn't better than anyone, or not even that, they're just trying to bring you down altogether because they feel the need to fill their insecurity, but bullying someone else or putting someone else down does not necessarily build yourself up. What you have to do is surround yourself with friends, not people who are two-faced. And two-faced means being one way in front of like someone, like one of my ex-friends. They were two-faced, so I had to get rid of them because they like brought me down so much that it was to the point that I went home crying every day. Until my mom said, until I was getting told that people who are two-faced do not belong in your friend zone. Only people who build you up. Two-faced people are nice to you in your face, but then have nerves, act like they got nerves to talk about you behind your back. What I feel is that you, if you want to say something positive, and if you have nothing positive to say, don't say anything at all. And if you feel like you absolutely have to say something negative to somebody, you might as well just write it in a book and burn the book. Even if that story's paper. But if that's what you have to do in order not to bring someone else down, then you absolutely should do that. But don't just go around putting people down and feeling like you're better than anyone else, because no one is better than no one else. I was told, and I'm still told this, if they don't put food on your table, they don't provide for you, they're not paying bills for you to live in a room, or providing for you in any way, then what does their opinion matter? It doesn't. Whether you feel like you should stoop down to their level or be pushed down so much that you can be in the put the emphasis on popular group. People talk about me all the time, but I don't let that get to me anymore. I never let that get to me anymore. If you have something to say, I will let you say it because you do have the freedom of speech.
but you're not going to get that into my head that I'm ugly, I'm no better than anyone else. I know I'm not no better than anyone else. I am in the same grade as some people are, and I am on the same level as most people are too. So whether you rich or not, that doesn't make you better than anyone else. So you can still be insecure and be rich, but you can also be a person who is honest and is nice too. So if you have something to say to somebody, it may well be a compliment or nothing at all. That's just my opinion, and I hope you agree to that too. And if you don't, you can write in the description, you can write in the comments, and please subscribe. But you can also write in the comments why you don't agree to that, and don't worry about your haters, because your haters are just your haters. They're always gonna hate. But this is what I say, and people say I'm fake for saying this. I wrote on my social studies book what I am to myself. I put, I am kind, I am beautiful, I am smart, I am intelligent. I am who I say I am, not what anybody else says I am. And anyone who thinks otherwise can say that all they want, but I don't hate, I appreciate. And I appreciate my haters for building me up to the strength that I am. And if you have to do that every day in front of your mirror before you leave the house and once you get back home, then do so. But as long as you don't let anyone bring you down, then you're good. Bye.